Howdy, Zowdy. Big Beefy Burger Buddy here, another episode of The Binding of Isaac Pettens. Tainted characters are kind of rough. As we have Bethany. Bethany is pretty rough. Take what you don't like about, losing fires. And move that on to, your items being your fires, so then when you lose one of those, you get like really sad. She's cool. And Cursed Eye, we can't not take Cursed Eye, right? That's just what is destined to be. What was the shop here? Was it okay? The map and the nickel. The map and the nickel. her default, like, not gaining as much stats from items is obviously not great, as, like, one damage up will not even probably break us past, like, 4.2 damage, assuming it's, like, a good one. And, you know, there's the chance that when you get a fire, you get, like, an item that's bad, so let's just... We gotta beat Delirium. Let's try to beat Delirium. There you go, my sack boy got shot. They at least have more health, which is nice. But she's kinda... She's gonna be rough with them stat ups, which aren't necessarily the most important things. I feel like a lot of these tainted characters just like benefit highly if you get like familiars. Like Eve? Tainted Eve is like... Just give me, like, Seraphine, and then, like, the game's easy. Like, this tears up is not gonna be the best. In fact, I think our tears cap is, like, slightly lowered, right? $3 bill's pretty cool. But I do like the gimmick of, instead of using the soul hearts to charge your items, you actually used red hearts, since you're locked to, soul hearts on this Bethany. Which it's nice because like a lot of the time red hearts kind of just serve no purpose. It's easy to just like have that be the consumable that you leave behind the most, so like being able to get some utility out of them is honestly like it's valuable. That's why I like things like blood rites and items like that, because they're actually like there is a use for those items. And we're actually getting some pretty good soul hearts. And honestly, whatever that item I just picked up is called, not bad, for sure. Also very lucky to get another Tinder Rock. Like, I wouldn't even mind if this was a gold chest. Ooh, not a bad trinket, honestly. Also super lucky we got that as well. You're getting a lot of those recently. Maybe if you get a couple, Nah, I'm gonna go with this penny. I feel like it'll end up serving more of a purpose, in the long run. Since, we will always be benefiting from picking up... the utility of our red hearts. Because we could spawn more familiars, or we could get a spacebar item that could be worth... having the health. Just kill this boss. Try not to get teleported out. And then we leave. Not great. I mean, it's an HP up. But realistically, we're not going to be able to use it. I think we go with the devil deals, right? See, I say that like with, hey, get more familiars. That's what we want. I'm going to go with it. Probably should have at least checked the, actually, I didn't even have bombs to do it, so. At least not two bombs to do it. So we're gonna go with the two familiars that we'll be getting most likely in every floor. Yeah, 9-inch nails like didn't even break the tier that damage that high. Couldn't be because of our lowered increase from stats. So if we lose our Boneheart on this character, do we actually lose our Devil Deal chance, or do we just, like, go to Comedy Planet? Also, this is charged, so we should probably use it. Oh, not that. I meant this. Proptosis. Proptosis is something we want to try to keep for as long as possible. Of course, it's another curse. Hey, you know what I just said about getting Cursed the Tower every run? Here's Cursed the Tower again. Thanks for shooting Proptosis, by the way. Really appreciate that one. So yeah, Cursed the Tower, Cursed the Eye, like, fuck it, right? Yeah, that's where we're at. Every run we gotta do this? Just like... You would think, like... Luck-wise, hey, you'd probably get, like... I will concede I do get pretty lucky with a lot of my runs. Especially if you were watching challenges recently. Where, like, every single challenge I was getting something, like, super strong. For that particular challenge. And then we have... I think I'm gonna just use this. Reasoning being, I don't want to waste the one charge. I think the one half a heart might just be more worth losing. But like, yeah, we get like, hey, I'm Bloody Mary. We get, we get placenta and, hot potato. We get an item that lets us stall our explosives. In fact, we get multiple items that let us do that. Thanks for increasing my range. Well, we can't get any of those. Not that I even wanted to get any of those, really. We do want to go get our item room, though. Our item room will be crazy. Ghost Baby. I like Ghost Baby. I don't like getting familiars out of my, my fires, though. Because then I feel bad when they die. That's that, that flame, caveat. That's not too bad, unless it tears up, unless they're shooting diagonals. Might not happen too often with, Curse of the Eye, Curse of the Eye Tower, Cursed Eye Tower. We just keep getting both. I haven't had Cursed Eye in a minute. So, like, I'll concede, like, hey, like, let's go back to being a little bit more, comical. But, like, how often do I really need to get Curse of the Tower? It's, like, a ridiculous amount. I want to know what percentage of my, like, last, like, 15 runs I had Curse of the Tower. I wonder how often it appears because of its rarity. I mean, it's in a lot of the item pools. So, like, you're probably gonna likely see it. Just, like, based off of that info alone. But, like... Why is it this often? Now, Delirium is scary. Because we could get in there with, like, subpar items, but a bunch of really good... flames, have them all die to his infinite spawning projectiles, and then where are we? Most likely dead is where we'd be. But hey, we get Sacred Heart. That would, make me a little bit more confident. Dry Baby's not bad. I'll take Dry Baby. Any day. I will also take a reroll. I'll do it. Not just because of, our current selection of items, but mostly just because, hey, rerolls are fun. But I would definitely say it was mostly because, well, we still have Curse of the Tower. So if we look at it like that, I mean, we still got Curse of the Tower. We did get Fruitcake, though, which has a lot of really good tier effects. So I'm not against that. And we still got Proptosis, at least for a little bit. What is happening with that tier? Also, I should probably grab this, especially because that's a lucky penny right there. Saw that little shimmer of green. That luck up's gonna be good. I don't know if I'm gonna even use the forget me now. I mean, we have a reason to, because hey, free item, free boss item, free everything. But like, also, we're trying to get to boss rush in time, and we want to beat boss rush, and most likely delirium and hush. Also, I think I just lost Proptosis. No, I still got it. I definitely lost something there. Proptosis is still there. Also, we lost our bone heart, and it didn't decrease our chance. We are doing a lot of random little flavors. Wow, could it be the item that does that? That does is causing all of these random tier effects? Another devil deal. So like, this is the run we get every devil deal. Unfortunately, we cannot take this item, which really sucks. Spider baby, Spelunker hat. Yeah, we just can't take it. Can't take Death's Touch. What a world. Maybe we can buy a soul heart and then we'll be put at half a soul heart. And then I'll buy this, because like, why not? Just don't kill myself on the spikes, like, and then we forget me now. Alright. So what is thing number one that has to happen here? That's crazy. One, we need to not blow ourselves up with a Epicac shot is probably priority number one. But we need to get one soul heart, which is possible at this shop. Don't reflect the shot back into my face. You know how mad I'm gonna be. Okay. Like, this run has potential now. As I see, like, two explosives. Be very close. I mean, we should probably, like, check this first. Okay, I think I hate this item with a passion. I hate it a lot. It's gonna screw us. I feel it. But I also feel this being greed. It wasn't worth it. It wasn't worth it. It was probably worth it. No, it was not worth it. But we always take pills. Sweet. Question marks. We're in a little bit of a pickle. Are you gonna make me re-roll again? I'll do it. I know I have like a game winning run stat wise, but I'll do it again. I can't keep wasting time on these floors. It's purgatory. We need to try to get to boss rush in time. I can't just keep, like, I think I'm gonna take this Holy Eve, honestly. But if, like, we weren't strapped for time, like, hey, maybe I'll do this. I feel like we're already probably kind of late to the boss rush party because of the timer we've been set with. And now that we have the speed down, like, maybe we can't even get there in time. Only caveat being the fact that, hey, maybe we'll be able to shot speed down. I mean, it could be worse. Cool. Hermit. I think we're taking, yeah, Soul of Eve. Thank you. I mean, Shield of Tears is gonna be the best thing we got right after getting, Death's Touch. Because Death Touch Piercing Tears is good. And then that Piercing Tear goes through all those projectiles, and then you can't die. That's honestly probably huge. Probably not that one. Vercaeus Veins. I almost just walked in that enemy. He probably just destroyed one of my wonderful items. These are one of the enemies that are kind of freaking me out. I think we got enough time to get to boss rush. Which we are doing boss rush, so. Maybe this will be a little bit easier. See, I normally hate Thunder Thighs, but I can't deny that it just gave me that 100%. I also can't deny that two of my best items probably just got deleted because I walked into. Yeah, we just lost Proptos. No, we didn't. Proptos is still somehow alive. But man, that loss of flames. I feel like if that enemy can't take damage, flames shouldn't break on it. But that's just me, I guess. We are just gonna stop stepping on them then. Stepping on the beach. Stepping on the fact that I got a shot right here. Something got damaged. I think it was the soul. Nothing we really want in there. Go and hit the book. Little Monstro. Let's use that vision. Worst room in the game? Potentially worst room in the game? Didn't get hit at least. Yeah, I feel like that's a big contender for just ultimate comedy room. That's kind of weird how that just happened. I think I'm gonna use this. Just die, just one of her flames. Like realistically, how do I not lose another heart there? I'm shocked I didn't get hit it a second time from the Curse of the Tower that we are fortunate enough to still have. At least we got rid of Cursed Eye, right? At this point, Cursed Eye would probably have been like the worst thing to get. Which was why we got it on our first item room. This boss sucks. Plus I still... For some reason I thought I was tricking myself into thinking I still had it. Because I had a little charge from Little Monstro there. But we don't, so just try to be happy. That's some good items, honestly. I'll check what's in here. Really nothing I want. I mean, maybe like Jello, but we also want to try to get to boss rush within the next 3.5 minutes. A lot of devil deals, though, on this floor. We've gotten, like, 4 devil deals, and we're not even depths 2. Well, we're now depths 2. We got, like, 4 devil deals. And, last run, we didn't even get an item that we benefited from. Realistically, I could have got, like, Horror of Babylon, but I, wasn't able to see my health for a couple floors, so we didn't. So that's why I didn't grab that one. They don't get hit here, lose any of my flames. Because we got some good flames right now. The mark? Oh, that could be bad. The mark is obviously like huge, huge little extra damage increase. That's gonna help us a lot. We are definitely on pace to get the boss rush at least. At least that, like, after you've beaten boss rush once, like, the only real thing to stop you from winning. Like, boss rush doing it normally is kind of hard. So, like, then you've got to be like, hey, then I can just skip this. Don't really know why I went in here. Kind of figured I'd probably be fighting Greed in here. I haven't seen him this run yet. Maybe... maybe no. Yeah, this has been a super easy mom fight already. Like a super easy one. Our flames probably just got damaged a little bit there. Luckily, the ones you get from Birthright are a little bit healthier, and they're also higher quality. So, like, we're probably gonna see them more often. Also, that is a Tears Up. Which we had already this run. Let's go ahead and use this. Tough Love. Let's do it. Get that Soul Eve in there. Help me kill some of these enemies. And then we just try to maintain some of the items we have. As most of these good flames have been just hurt a little bit. That's really good. The Intruder. Yeah, I'll take Intruder. Again, familiars are super good on most of these Tainted characters. As you don't gotta worry about scaling on them. And, maybe just always have an Intruder. So, that's not bad. Admittedly, like, that Birthright pickup was crazy with the fact that we got both Deadeye and also the fact that we got Bloody Lust. Or Lusty Blood, I think. Because they did a weird rename of one of them and then, yeah, the other one's like, you know what I mean, they do one is to get, they do the damage, you get the kills. The other one is, you take the damage, you do the damage. There's Fruitcake causing me to get hit for the first time this run. I can hardly be mad at it with the amount of good it's done for me this run, because Fruitcake is honestly, like, it's just a better version of $3 Bill. Because a lot of the tier effects you get from Fruitcake are honestly, like, very, very strong. For some reason, I thought that creep on the ground was, Monstro 2's. That is, in fact, my creep. I'm a bit creepy. I'm a bit scary. But yeah, we're at the risk, Curse of the Tower, by the way. And you know, game, I do, like, see the sense in irony, but, like, what you really realize you gotta do right here? Yeah, no, my brain is, like, totally, like, just fried today, I guess. That's what happens when you're sick and don't sleep well. But what you gotta realize, game, is that I've already got Curse of the Tower. You can't hurt me. I'm stronger than you'll ever believe. Is that both the pins? Seems to be both the pins. Thanks for the money, because, like, almond milk. Probably gonna make the run a lot worse. I mean, almond milk's okay. Almond milk at least has the caveat of half of them having the hookworm. But I am definitely at a higher risk of blowing myself up with a tear. So we'll have to keep that one in mind. Other than that, I think we're good. It is really funny to see a bunch of like really tiny Scythes flying everywhere though. I do like this. And there's so many that any projectile on screen that is shot by an enemy is probably not gonna end up mattering. And then that's boss rush. Nod Leaf. I don't think it's gonna get too much use. Realistically. Hot bombs, that's not bad. But, we'll try to see what we can find its use out of. Alright, well, we got hit. Thankfully, I can't really see where I'm at. There's I feel like I'm getting, guillotined right now. Like, it's hard to see where your character is, so you can avoid damage. But mostly due to the items I'm currently running around with. I keep hearing those explosives and they're freaking me out. Because they can hurt me. Shock they haven't yet. At least while I have almond milk enabled. I think we just keep going, right? Like, we go for comedy? I think we just spam this book after like a certain amount of time. Like, admittedly, this run is crazy good. Like, I'm willing to go for like a delirium kill on this. Like, cause this is strong. So we're just gonna- Ludovo, fuck Ludovo, man. That's gonna kill the run. Fucking Ludovo fucking technique. What a fucking useless item. Like, a guaranteed just decrease on your run. Like, your stats are now fucking shit on. Like, any amount of hope you had, it's all gone. Because, like, your DPS has effectively been cut into a tenth of what it was. And not like I know where I can even find Ludovo. Because I think it's in the center. I'm trying to see, maybe. Which one even is Ludovo? I can't tell. I also can't tell because I'm getting flashbanged by my goddamn tears. Let's see. I think I do see Ludovo in the center there. Car battery, spider baby. That looks like Ludovo there. So yeah, we're stuck with it. Unfortunate. I mean, maybe that'll be good. Maybe that'll be good against the- we'll have to see how this boss fight goes. I mean, that's some good damage. That is good damage. So, maybe... maybe not a Ludothrow? To get Ludovo? We're gonna keep going, by the way. I think the worst thing I could get now would be Curse of the Eye. Like, Cursed Eye. We're just gonna lose a bunch of flames there. We just have a lot of them. Scorpio. Like, this is what this character usually builds to be. Is like... just go for it, you know? I didn't even see what, like, those items were. But, hey. Now, oh, no. We have what? Oh, we need those. I need at least one of these half-soul hearts. I think I've made a mistake. I'm not gonna own up to it. Like... so I say I think I made a mistake, but you know, we could have done it a little smarter, at least like paste it so I knew what I picked up. but yeah, we're gonna try to be hush. Where am I? I'm thinking this run's gonna go. Ooh, juicy sack. I know what this item's called instead of sticky babies because of last run. Nope. I want that. What we really want is another item. Angelic Prism is crazy good. Because that's gonna make my brain hurt even more. Yeah, we... What did I walk into? I guess I didn't kill the eyeball because I can't really aim at it. Yeah, I'm realizing Hush is probably gonna be super easy. Possibly Delirium. Yeah, I got a decent amount of health. I don't gotta worry about that. And just in time for Stat Booster to really be what we need to try to get this run to full perfection. Didn't want to blow that up. I was actually gonna donate to that. It's not like I control that. I'm taking Bulbatar. I mean, we already got Juicy Sack for that. Upper C's okay. I don't even have any keys. Do we need them though? No. Because this is realistically going to be one of the easiest Hush fights I've ever fought. Like, I can probably stand in the corner and not get affected. Yeah, tier size. Does, hey, piercing shot, shielded tears. He will not be able to shoot tears at me. I probably have so much money on the ground. The game crashed. Yeah, I'll be back momentarily. Oh! Okay. Alright, here's what we know, right? One, we want to donate all this money. And quite honestly, none of our items are great. So I guess I'm so strong that I'm crashing the game. Which is not good. Euthanasia. So apparently your tears change. Definitely was not expecting a game crash. So what, do I gotta make a rule? Like, if I literally can't win this... Also, I'm realizing all of my, flames have now... like... become one layer around me? They just kind of reset, that's weird. But what if I literally can't physically beat this? I think what crashed the game is he spawned the flies and then, like, a bunch of tier effects... probably, like, cause them all to die and spam a bunch of projectiles and maybe that crashed the game. I'm not a huge expert on, Isaac. Mechanically. But certainly something was not handled correctly by the game. But yeah, that is actually a first. Very funny. If I'm gonna crash, it's gonna be this. It's gonna be this run. Like, I'm fully okay with it. We just need to hopefully not crash again. Now, I'm gonna say it right now. Because it reset the floor, like, whatever. Like, we... what happened. Soul of Bethany we get for beating that. Yeah, we get a bunch of health, too. That's actually really good. And it keeps happening. So if we crash a bunch, trying to get to Delirium here, like, if I go fight Delirium and something similar happens, he just crashes. Just to save time, I am just gonna, like, probably, like, full card Or not full card. Just like use console to go just teleport to that boss fight again. Because it already feels really cheesy that the game could crash and just give me another attempt. But also, I just don't want to be here all day if the game... I handled it that time, so I don't know what changed. Probably shouldn't make more... Should probably not make more guys, though. I'm just one of the only enemies that can really feasibly hit me. This is like... I thought Ludovo was going to kill this run. And in all honesty, Ludovo does have a habit of doing that. But like... Also, that... I don't know what broke the purple flame in the center there. I like how it just bounces around. Like in random spots. That's kind of funny. Oh wow, you're actually getting to shoot tears because... They're actually coming out your hands. Hey, Satan's kind of a weirder fight with Ludovo. Yeah, my bad, Ludovo. I feel like the strength of this run is not really Ludovo's doing, though. I feel like even with... without it, we'd still be pretty strong. I did lose a flame there. Maybe Ludovo's, like, buffing up my damage with, Proptosis, assuming I still have it. Also, this can't actually be, Delirium, so we're just gonna go ahead and kill him real quick, get an HP up. Could end up needing it, hopefully won't. Just gonna go ahead and... Smack these guys with the scythe. Hey, there's stairway. Okay, so we needed stairway this late in the game. Every time I see this room, I'm just like, yeah. I'd rather take a heart of damage than actually do it. That just really proves my laziness. Also, can you blame me? I knew I was gonna get hit there. I knew you were gonna drop creep on the ground. And there was no way I was gonna see it. So I should have adjusted accordingly. Hey, lucky penny. I just hope this is delirium right here. Damn, not delirium. I really don't want to go looking around for him, you know. So I remember this. Just trying to grab my cards. It's just like... I mean, we could... Just get a couple more items, you know? Yeah, I could go to my super secret room there. Probably should. Probably a lot of things I should do in this run, you know? That's just, like, comedy. Give me that. There's really no point to me having, a lover's card, just not using it, so I might as well just do that. We always take pills, but... Don't even gotta worry about grimaces. Health up. That's nice. Having a lot of fun. this run is, I think, the most fun I've ever had on Tainted Bethany. I'm gonna be honest. If I could get more runs like this, then you know I'm all for it. Maybe that's gonna be my strat from, like, from here on out with this character. Just kinda like, do I actually get charges for these? No. Am I immune to explosions? I gotta be. Oh. Wait, I might be, because the Curse of the Tower didn't hurt me. Unless, the flames just blocked it. I think that's probably what it was. Cracked orb. What the? I don't know what to say past, hey, this is one of the best runs I've ever had. It was certainly not in a character I would have expected it on. But it's, certainly a character that deserves it, all things considered. I mean, look at this comedy. I feel like this, despite how, like, broken hilarious this run is right now, there's still a high likelihood we die to this boss. Just because maintaining Ludovo is kind of hard. Fighting a boss that, you know, can teleport around. But, so we're just going to try to be, like, far away if we can be. Like, that could hit me. Yeah. I should just say that will hit me whenever I see that boss spawn. Okay. Okay, luckily I just didn't walk into those spikes. Got knocked around a little bit there. Wow, being invincible over here, Delirium? What are you? A loser? Little invulnerable loser, little loser guy? Forgive me if I'm tired, but I don't think I was mentally prepared for a run like this. But yeah, it was extremely fun. The game crashed. Oh, yeah, I had a 100% blast playing that one. Honestly, to start Tainted Bethany, I was expecting to go a lot worse, but hey, we got some comedy. If you enjoyed this run, leave a like, comment, subscribe if you haven't. Join my Discord, links in the description. I'll see you in the next one. We unlocked Megaton!